Excellencies, dear colleagues. At this debate today, our delegation would like to address two issues: illicit financial flows and investment in sustainable infrastructure. The figures presented in the report of the FACTI panel are shocking. $1 trillion is taken out of developing countries each year by criminals. $20 to $40 billion is in the form of bribes received by the corrupt. $7 trillion in stolen assets is parked in heaven countries. $500 to $600 billion is lost each year in tax avoidance by multinational companies. These flows stifle economic growth and embed poverty and inequality. This bleeding of the poorest countries must stop. We must have a robust mechanism for the return of stolen assets of developing countries. Destination countries need to punish the enablers of illicit finances, banks, accountants, lawyers, and eliminate safe haven for such money. A fair and equitable tax regime with minimum corporate tax is essential for combating profit shifting by multinational corporations and tax evasion and avoidance. Revenues from digital transactions should be taxed where the revenues are generated, not elsewhere. Unequal investment treaties should be discarded or revised, and a fair system be set up for education of investment disparities. The measures implemented by governments in the context of COVID-19 should be immune from any claims against them by companies and corporations. Bodies set up to monitor illicit financial flows should not be used for financial or political coercion of developing countries. A UN mechanism needs to be established to oversee and coordinate the work of the various official and private bodies which deal with illicit financial flows. Madam Chair, there is no single type of investment more essential for achievement of SDGs than sustainable infrastructure, impacting 92% of all SDG targets. We need to mobilize an additional 1.5 trillion investment annually for the developing countries in sustainable infrastructures. There is vast amount of finance in the markets earning negative interest rates. This would be more productively utilized for investment in sustainable infrastructure. President ECOSOC has proposed the establishment of an infrastructure investment facility as a public-private partnership to develop and harmonize policies and assist in the preparation of sustainable infrastructure projects in the developing countries. Our delegation looks forward to a more in-depth discussion of the proposal when the second committee holds a joint meeting with the ECOSOC in the next few days. I thank you, Madam Chair.
I thank the distinguished delegate from Pakistan.